You thought there was only going to be one video today, but you were wrong! Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Rabi-Ribi, and to make up for the lack of content I've been doing, I decided to make a second video today. Today we're going to visit the exotic laboratory and see if we can help out our friend Sayoro. And I forgot to switch my attacks. There we go. It's nice that the bullets clear when you kill an enemy. So that's always good. Nothing here, so let's keep looking. This badge is actually quite effective. This way. Also, I don't know what those enemies are. I guess they're sentries or something? What's this? Oh dear! It's a screw bomber. Let's wait for it to stop attacking. There we go. What's this? Weaken. Huh. So it makes them more susceptible to attacks. Interesting. I guess I can put that on for now. I have plenty of health as it is. I have to say, this place is very much drilling home the whole Metroid Fusion look. Kind of reminds me of, you know, the space station from that game. I forgot what it was called. Something Science Center Station. I don't even need the charge saw. I can just keep shooting the regular laser shot. Oh dear. Oh boy. Oh, so they're robot maids. I don't know. They don't look like your typical maids. They look more like a, you know, typical scientists with the lab coats and everything. Roger, Rabbit. And, oh dear. We have lasers to deal with, as in actual lasers that are going to hurt us if we touch them, so let's try not to touch them. Couldn't quite make it. And further lasery goodness. Looks like we hit a dead end. But I think we can destroy these blocks. Yep, we can. But unfortunately, we can't go any further because tight passages. See, more and more of them lately. Does this mean we're gonna be able to get a power-up for them soon? Okay, we should be close to our objective at least, so, huh? Yeah, my thoughts exactly. Huh? Well, we can't get through the small passages, but we can pick up this item here. Sliding powder. Huh. Okay, then. So yeah, we got the Mega Man slide now. Yoink. Can I go any further? Oh well. Also, as you saw, there is a new items in the shop. We'll have to check that out later. For now. Let's just keep going. Find out these lunchbox enemies and these annoying things that love to drop those energy balls. They've caught me multiple times in the past, but not this time! Except maybe this. What is this? Oh, it's an even bigger lunchbox. So far, all it wants to do is just chuck grenades at us. Ow! Oh yeah, nah, this is basically a tutorial on how to use the slide effectively. Kind of like in Mega Man 3. Let's finish you off. Ow. And you're dead. I don't know why, but I think that cross-shaped explosion was supposed to be a reference to Maple Story. Bosses explode in a similar fashion. Interesting, she says. Yes. That killer lunchbox was... Lunchbox/refrigerator was fun and interesting. Is there anything here? Oh, would you look at that? There is. Oh dear, there's a lot of lasers here. Now, what could be at the very back here? More and more lasers. Breakable walls and everything. And oh my, we already have a weaker version of the... boss. Oops. There we go. Get rid of that. Oh. Oh dear. Well, I'm still playing on easy difficulty, so it's not like I can't avoid some of these things. Get out! Ugh. Not pleasant! Also, thank goodness for tiny hitboxes. DLC? Hmm. I guess this is supposed to be another area that they'll add later. On that note, while I'm here, I might as well try something, because there's another secret technique we can use if we hold down the melee button. Oh, it reveals our hitbox! So this is actually kind of useful for positioning ourselves for maneuvering around the lasers, though it's only visible when you're actually walking for some reason. Kind of useful, that. And of course, if you're in a hurry like me, you could just face tank the lasers. There we go. Oof. Yeah, they only do like 4 damage. Oops. Yep. Don't care. We'll be fine. Can I wall jump up this? Yeah, I'm not feeling it today, apparently. Not to mention doing a wall jump up that shaft would be surprisingly hard. Do I want to go left or right? Let's go right. And we wind up back here, apparently. But we can now go this way. Also, while sliding, you cannot change direction. This isn't like Mega Man, where you can change direction while sliding. Speaking of wall jumps, though, I want that egg. I want that egg. Hearing noises downstairs. Is someone trying to call me? Okay, I can do it in that direction, I know. There we go! Finally! Timing on this is still pretty wonky. I have not been able to figure it out yet. Can't go up that way yet, or can I? Oh! Takes me up here. Okay, so let's... what's over here? Wait, didn't I just come this way? Ow. Yes, yes, I did. Also, I want that health pickup. I want this health pickup badly. Yep, there we go. That's good. And you, sir, are dead. Gotta comb over every area thoroughly. Because this place is kind of complicated to navigate. And that's a one-way passage. Dang it. Okay, am I supposed to fall down here? Okay, yeah, looks like I'm going this way. And how nice, there's a healing spot here. No, I don't need it, because I'm... how much health do I have? Status... Oh, it keeps track of what bosses you defeated at what rank. That's useful. And we have another teleporter here. That's always nice. Unfortunately, this is not so nice. This boss is kind of irritating. Yeah, I don't have a clear idea on how to dodge that attack. And most of the time, this defense system is going to be stuck in that stupid whirly gig phase. Ow. Oh, dang it, I wasted it. Stupid me. But on the plus side, I did quite a number on the boss here. Oh dear, it's shooting. Though, really, this boss isn't too hard to dodge its attacks. You just have to know when to jump and when to slide. Particularly here. Yeah, get out of my face. I don't like you. But we beat the boss. Surely there is nothing to worry about here. Can't get up there yet. Can't wall jump, can't double jump yet. Because, let's face it, every single Metroidvania game, or at least most of the ones that I know of, have some kind of a wall jump kind of thing. Oh, there's a save point here, and how nice. And there's a secret room here. Let's see what's inside. Nasty surprise, that. Pack up. Pack points increased. What does that mean? Also, I think I can kind of see the seams on some of these tiles here. I don't know if that's a graphical error. Anyways, yeah, we got a pack point so we can equip more badges right now. That might come in handy later, but... For now, I'll just equip this. Anything here? Avoid the spring. In fact, I don't want to hit that spring, because that'll just propel me back to earlier in the level. Definitely a nasty trap, that. So let's go back to the main path. Yeah, there were some screw bombers hidden in those walls. Anything else here? Any other nasty surprises I should be aware of? Also, hey, obvious item is obvious. We get the boulder badge! I mean, the attack up! Speaking of which, I need to get that other attack up from earlier in the area, back in the Twilight Forest. Excuse me. Well, that's nice of you. Does this mean that Sassini was from the world we just visited? I have a feeling we're gonna have to go back in there and maybe go inside the computer to rescue Sayaro. This is just speculation on my part, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be true. Look, we got some intel from our fairy friends. Well, it looks like Sassini's cleaned up her act a little bit. You didn't waste our time. We got a couple of useful power-ups. And away they go. Okay, then. And for completing that little side quest, we got us some more cash. Definitely useful. So we have another destination, the Golden Pyramid. And that's it. Yeah, Golden Pyramid. We also have to check out a Rabi-Ribi Ravine. First, let's do some shopping. See if we can get any more unique power-ups. Okay. It's clear there's a wall jump in this game as an actual item. Spike barrier. That's cool. Air dash. Bunny strike. We don't have any of these yet, but we can collect a level up these items now. So, we'll have to find some more of those then. For now, let's upgrade the bunny amulet. Okay, that's maxed. And we'll get a level up in the auto earrings too. And that'll do for now. I don't want to buy any of these items just yet. I'll do it so when I upgrade the other power-ups in the shop. Oh, what's this? The Bunny Strike! Interesting. And we have enough money to buy us a level in a bunny strike. Alright, good. Let's get on out of here and I can demonstrate that bunny strike. So you want to slide, then use the melee attack. You need a lot of SP, but it's useful for closing the distance between enemies, and I did that improperly. Oh well. Jeez, I am just boggling up all the things today. In any case, let's go back to the Twilight Forest and get that power-up I missed. Shouldn't take long. Yeah, I'm really liking this badge upgrade. Yay. Now I have to climb my way back out. Actually, I wonder if I can just wall jump out. Might be a little tricky, but... Or I can just completely mess up to jump. That works too. I wonder if I can just go back up this way. Yep. In fact, I could have grabbed this power-up sooner, but eh, whatever. Let's not fall down again, thank you. Oh, whoops. Right then. So let's, teleport back. To where? Oh yeah, we still have to go to, Rabi-Rabi Ravine. Yeah. Which is fitting. Because I know what boss we're gonna meet there next. Wait. Sassini, I thought you were busy at the lab. Maybe she's back in town to get some more parts for the computer or something, I don't know. Let's just continue on our way. Oh, jerks. Take that. All right, we're back in Rabi-Rabi Ravine. So let's begin exploring. Come on, get up there. There we go. Jerk. Yeah, those egg enemies are kind of a pain to hit, but they're not that bad. Oops. Okay. Let's see if I can actually get that blasted health power up. There we go! So far, so good. Let's get rid of you. You gotta check all the walls. You never know if you're gonna find a power-up or a secret egg or something. Nope. Nope. Anything. Oh! Didn't mean to do that! I don't want to save just yet. Can I just, cancel out? There we go. Oh, would you look at that? There's a secret passage here. Oh, it's just a shortcut of sorts. Well, it's better than nothing, I guess. And this just takes us back to the save room. I think I went to this room before. Yeah, I did, actually. There was a power-up here. Okay, well, let's, okay, way to interrupt my slide, you jerks. Yeah, Yeah, it just goes up to a save point. And oh, right, I can use the shortcut I discovered earlier. That's always nice. And if I want to use the save point, I can. Get back here, you. Alright, let's actually begin our little climb. Excuse me. Can I make this jump this time? Nope! I completely and utterly botched it up. Yes, laser is probably the best weapon for you taking out those egg-shaped enemies. Okay, I'll give it one more try, and if I can't do it, I'll just skip it. Nope! I feel like I need a double jump for that. I mean, I got it, like, once before, but I really think you need the double jump for that sort of thing. Don't like this place. There's too many bumps and such to get your head hit upon. Nope. Well, my destination is over there, at least. We get a new enemy type. These moles here chuck rocks at you. Yeah, okay, yeah. I kind of want to get down there, and I want that whatever it is. Is it a badge? I think it's a badge. It's been a while. Oh, yeah. There's a warp stone here. Hey. We are a bunny. Jeez. Well, no, it's not a forest, it's like a mountain. So now we can warp back to town whenever we feel like it. Yeah, I could do that if I wanted to, but... Nah, I'm not gonna bother. I may like Metroidvania-esque games, where it comes to sequence breaking, I am pretty weak sauce. And you're just an annoying little so-and-so. Well, let's at least go up and see what's in this room. Okay, we're at max power. There's another pickup there. Nice. Yeah, let's get rid of you guys. If we go over. Oops, there's a rock there. This way. Yeah, there we go. We get into the little container where the health pickup is, though it looks like I'm not gonna get out of there anytime soon. So, backtracking we go. Oops. right then. Keep on going and keep forgetting that there are enemies here. At least we'll get another egg, and now I can't get out. Great. And more backtracking. Lovely. Yeah, you kind of have to go around the horn a few times to get some of these power-ups. Get rid of you guys. What's up here? Is there anything up here? Where am I even going? Okay, well, I have to kind of go down to reach my destination. Looks like if I... Should I take this? Should I try this? No! Oh, crud. Oh, crud. I saw something up there. I knew I saw something up there, so I guess I gotta go back once again. I am good at video games. Get out of my face. Get out of my face. Okay. You lot. Well, let's first go up and see what this room is all about. Can't quite wall jump up there yet, so no point in doing that. Okay. Oh no! Oh, good. I can get back in here. What is this? Hammer wave! Oh, it's that... It's that attack that our evil self used against us. Cool. So now we can hit enemies from a distance too, though. I already had this laser for that, so... It has its uses. It has its uses. You're gonna fall off the ledge there, Chief? Yes, you are. Okay, let's not screw this one up this time. Go up here. Grab another power-up. Oh dear. I got knocked off. But I can at least get back up this... Darn it. Oh well, I think I got everything I could up there, so... Let's heal ourselves up a bit, because, as usual, there's gonna be a boss fight next. We've gone quite a fair bit, so... Well, I may or may not have found that same path you were talking about, miss, so don't worry too much. Oh, hello there. Yep, there. She's wearing an identical outfit to Vanilla. Okay, then. Good gravy. Once again. Poor Arena. She's ashamed of being a bunny girl. Of being a bunny in general. Oops, I jumped right into that, didn't I? But yeah. This is our boss fight against Chocolate, and she's got some pretty advanced magic too. She disappears like her sister, and she does all these fancy bullet patterns. Perhaps even more than her sister does. You're gonna show up? Yes, you are. Oh. Yeah, it might be a good idea to pay attention to where the bullet trajectories are actually coming from. Oh, what is this? Bullet walls? Okay, I could vault that pretty easily. And you can tell she has a lot of health! Oh. Oh man, she just does not want to stay in one place for too long. Here, have some lasers. And she only got one hit in. That's irritating. Oof. She's using her super already? That's not a good sign. And that laser is also kind of irritating to dodge. You have to get behind her before she fires it. And I completely missed. No, stop being defensive. I know you're a boss character, but come on. Oh, numb? How'd she get me with that? Oof. Oh great, now she's got this bullet barrier thing. Just hold still. Oh no. She's really going all out on the Danmaku here. Die anytime, please. Thank you! Thank you, Ribbon! Hey, I got a D-rank finish this time. Yeah, I would not recommend that. That face there she makes. Yeah, that is a little bit unfortunate, but what can you do? I'm closing out on my my quote-unquote time limit. But there is actually somewhere else we can go to get another helper. Yeah, right. I know just where to go, but I have to find my way over there. Ugh, why is the transport stone so far away? It's tucked in a corner like that. Oh well. I can just go back to town. That's probably the easiest way. What do you gotta say? Ooh, and why does she have a bandage on her eye too? What the heck? Oh yeah, that's right. Sometimes the characters you recruit will cast a temporary buff spell on you. These are nice, but they cost money to use, and I honestly don't need them at the moment. It's funny how she suddenly changes her tune after knocking us around so senselessly. Yow. Okay, here we are. Actually, hold on. Can I buy another upgrade? Yeah, these two will give you buffs too. Sassini gives speed. I don't know what Vanilla gives. Ah, yeah, we can upgrade the Bunny Strike again. And while I'm on the subject of speed, I might as well get the speed boost as soon as I can get the cursor to land on the right item. There we go. Good, good, good. Thank you, Miriam. Right then, so let's go back to the warp stone. And go over. There we go. Back to Rabi-Rabi Park. And if we go to the left here, we'll find ourselves in the Azure Snowland. Yeah, the both of you should. She has a point there. Yeah, again, I think it's a subtle, another quote-unquote subtle Playboy Bunny reference. Anyways, let's continue onwards and, oh! A new enemy type. Quite durable, that. Alright. Get another health upgrade. That's always welcome. Also, do yourself a favor and don't go for a swim here. The water will slow you down, and there's an entire area that's pretty much covered in it. And we don't need to visit it right now. What we do need to do is avoid these snowballs. Split the smaller snowballs. We'll just ignore the underwater area for now. Is there something else in here? No, I guess not. Oh well, let's keep going onward and upward. That can happen. Well, while she's preoccupied. Nope. Nothing's here. Oh well. Hey, it's those cat enemies again. Oh well. There's another magic upgrade there. Can I get it? Yes, yes, I can. Excellent. I'm checking the map again. Okay. Can I go in here? Oh, yes! Another useful pickup, the Quick Barrette. Nice. We get slightly faster charge shots, I guess. And another underwater area. Always check the walls. You never know what you're gonna find. So, let's get out of here and continue on our way. Oh, good gravy. First rocks and now these fangs. Stay dead! And again, water. Makes me wonder how these ladies breathe underwater. How anyone breathes underwater. Is this a special kind of universe where everyone has gills or something? I don't know. But I can't quite reach that ledge. Can I wall jump up there? Yes, I can actually. Oh goodness, no, I just remembered. Oh yeah, I don't want to go up there just yet. Or do I? I'll risk it. It's not that bad. There's enemies with lots and lots of damaku and lasers and it's not pleasant. Okay, I need to find the transport stone here. So I can come back to this place later. So far, I am having zero. Here we are! Yay! Okay, good. Now I can come back to this place whenever I want. And just for the record, this is the Northern Tundra. Frickin' lasers! And there's another place we can drop in on, I guess. Oh. Okay, you could have also gone up there, but eh. Yeah, it's not really worth the effort at all to go all the way up there yet. Cuz there are so many annoying enemies, it's just gah. So let's just keep going and reach our actual destination. Uh-oh. Bunnies in the sky. Oh, it's Rita. And my phone decided to go off. I don't know if anyone heard that, but uh-oh. What's going on? Wait, music? Oh dear. Rita's gonna fight us. That's pleasant. As you could probably guess from her theme and the magic she's throwing, she's an ice user. Thankfully, she's not too hard, even if you fight her early on. Oh dear, what? I still got hit by that stupid attack. How are you supposed to avoid that? I've never been able to figure out how. And she loves using that snowflake attack. But it's not that hard to dodge once you realize what how it's supposed to work, and she is doing a snow geyser move. Well, I can still damage her at least. Oof. I am not doing very good at this fight. Oh, I didn't even see that bullet there. Oh dear. Yeah, this is really one of those show don't tell kind of fights. There's just so much going on, and it's kind of hard to keep track sometimes. Oh dear. What the? Was that a fan? Oh well, whatever. She's dead. Well, dead in quotation marks.
Excuse me.
Well, we didn't know that. Excuse us. Oh, dear. Well, at least we have an idea of what's going on with the plot. There's some kind of mystery surrounding Arena's transformation in these sky bunnies. See ya. Alright, we got another helper, and now we can go back to Rabi-Ribi Town for another round of Stele exploration. So, I will end the video here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Until then, have a good evening.